can make the leader fall, if he can make the leader go astray, if he can make the leader sin, then it's easier for him to wreck the work of the church.
Come on.
Amen. And we know that Satan is trying to destroy the church and the kingdom of Christ. And so he goes after the leaders. And if that, you can be a pastor, an elder, a deacon, a teacher, the president of the United States, anybody who is in a position of leadership and authority is first in line to be attacked by the enemy. There's something about Satan that causes him to despise leadership. There's something about him that causes him to despise order. Amen. He wants all of us to fall so that we'll all be sheep without a shepherd, lost, weak, and helpless. When we line up with God, we automatically line up against Satan. And so Satan comes in and he tries to throw all kinds of hindrances and setbacks in our paths to attempt to show us that following God and serving God and doing the things of God does not pay off. He comes to the church, he comes in on our jobs, he comes in at home and tries to wreak all sorts of havoc in our lives. He even comes into the church and tries to discourage us as saints in the very place that we try to build a spiritual foundation. Amen. We come and say that we want to serve the Lord and we do our best to follow and follow hard after him. And even while we're in the house of God, the enemy is yet there trying to cause division and trying to cause strife. Amen. But the scripture says, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan hath desired to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for thee, that thy faith fail not. And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. What he's saying here to Peter, when he's saying that the enemy is desiring to sift him as wheat, what he's saying is that in spite of your loyalty, in spite of your pledge and your devotion to me, the enemy is still trying to sift you. Despite the fact that you've decided that you are going to go all the way with the Lord, he's not paying that any regard. He's still going to try to sift you. Despite the way you have served me, despite the way you've paid your tithes and offerings, despite the way you've come to church every Sunday, the enemy still wants to sift you as wheat. Don't think for a moment, just because you have identified yourself as a disciple of Christ, that the enemy no longer wants to take a hold of your soul. That's simply not the truth. Simply not the truth. Which brings me to my second point. Even though the enemy wants to destroy us, God wants to deliver us. He says here, even though he wants to shift you as wheat, Jesus says, but I prayed for you. Amen. I prayed for you. The enemy wants everyone who has given themselves to God, and God wants everybody who has given themselves to the enemy. Amen. Somebody say everybody.
Everybody.
There are times in your life when you are so burdened and so discouraged that you don't have you don't have the will to pray. Sometimes we are so burdened down and heavy laden and things are going on in our lives and we're turned upside down and we don't know what's going on. We don't have the time to pray. We don't have what it takes in us to pray. And sometimes we feel even if we did, we couldn't pray our way out of a paper bag. We couldn't get out of the situation that we're in. But I've come to tell you this morning that Jesus has prayed for you. When the enemy has confused you to the point where you don't know what's going on, to the point where you're so tired and weary and don't even know if you can make it to the next hour, the next minute, the next second, I want you to find strength this morning in knowing that the Lord has prayed for you. Amen. And there is value in prayer. Amen. Someone say value in prayer. Turn to Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8, verse 26 and 27. And the word of the Lord reads, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. So you have no idea of the prayers and the intercession that is going on your behalf. As a matter of fact, it's those prayers that you know not of that have got you to the point that you are today. And just because you don't hear it, just because you don't always necessarily see it, know that there is intercession going on your behalf. Amen. You've not come this far on your own. Only but by the help of God are we here where we are today. Amen. When the Lord's spoke to Peter at this point, Peter had no idea of what the enemy had in store. As a matter of fact, today we have no idea what the enemy has in store. We know that the enemy has come to work against us, to sift us, to bring us down, to destroy us, but that's all we know. We really don't know the intricate workings or the intricate plans that the enemy has prepared for us. Peter did not know at this point in just a very few hours that the shepherd would be taken away and the sheep would scatter. He didn't know that soon he would have to stand by himself and either affirm or deny the very Christ.
My Lord.
He did not know that at that very moment, Satan was close to tearing apart the disciples. He didn't know any of this that was going on. Just the way we don't know what's going on. But I've come to tell you this morning that even though we don't know what the next attack may be, God knows, and he's praying for us. Amen. In the midst of our storms, we have to continue to have faith in God. Amen. We have to have faith and hold on to that faith until our change comes. Amen. Until our change comes, we have to hold on to every word that the Lord has said. Amen. The scripture says that men shall not live by bread alone, but out of every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Amen. I want you to know that there's some words that have proceeded out of the mouth of God that have kept you to this point. There are some words that have proceeded from the mouth of God that have brought you healings. There are words that have proceeded out of the mouth of God that have brought you victory and deliverance and have kept you safe from hurt, harm, and danger. Amen. So you ought not to complain in any situation that you're in. Amen. Because you know it not what the Lord has kept you from. Amen. I don't know what the Lord has kept me from, but what I do know is that he's kept me. Amen. If that's your testimony this morning, say he's kept me. Look at your neighbor and say he's kept me. Amen. We have to trust God in spite of everything that's going on. Amen. In spite of broken wealth, we have to trust God. When the money's not in the bank and we don't know where the next penny is coming from, we've got to trust God. In spite of broken friendships, we have to trust God. In spite of broken promises, we have to trust the Lord. Truth be told, we've been disappointed on many occasions.
Yes,
amen. The truth be told, we have been let down.
Yes,
amen. But I've come to tell you this morning, if you will but trust and believe in God, that he will see you through. Amen. I don't know how he's going to do it. I don't know when he's going to do it. Amen. But my faith causes me to believe, amen, that it's on the way. Amen. And what you have to do in this hour is you have to hold on until the change comes.
Yes.
Because we serve a God who cannot lie. Amen. And he says that it's coming, amen, I'm going to believe that it's coming. Amen. I bless God that it's coming and it's on the way. Amen. It doesn't matter what you're going through. Know that you can make it. Amen. Despite the fact that the enemy desires to rip you down, amen, you serve a God who desires to build you up. Amen. And we need to build one another up as well. Amen. And this is the same. The enemy wanted to shift Job as well. We know about the story of Job. And the only thing that kept Job holding on was his faith in God.
Yes.
Let's look at Job chapter 19. Job chapter 19, verse 25. Job 19, 25. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and not mine eyes shall behold, and not another, though my reins be consumed within me. But ye should say, why persecute we him, seeing the root of the matter is found in me? Amen. Look again at go back to verse 25. It says, for I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, and in though after everything I've been through, I am seemingly destroyed, amen, my faith is still standing in the one, amen, who gives me victory. Amen, my faith is still standing in the one who has assured me, amen, that it shall come to pass. Amen, the songwriter said, though the storms keep on raging in my life, and sometimes it's hard to tell my night from day, amen, though the hope that lies within is reassuring, as I keep my eyes upon that distant shore,